I'm Dr. Golo Maura, and I lead BirdLife Australia's Key Biodiversity Area program. The KBA program is BirdLife Australia's way of looking after the most important places for birds and nature. We work with the community to identify nature's hotspots across Australia and implement the necessary conservation actions. Because KBAs are identified using a global standard, we can work with partners and governments around the world to save the most important places left for life on Earth. BirdLife Australia's projects are using KBAs to strengthen our conservation work and save the country's most threatened bird species.
Hi, my name's Dan Weller. I work at BirdLife Australia on the Shorebirds 2020 National Shorebird Monitoring Program. Today we're down at Western Treatment Plant in Werribee, Victoria, undertaking a shorebird monitoring survey. Surveys like the one we're doing here today are undertaken by volunteers right around the country and have been undertaken by volunteers for the past 30 or 40 years in some cases. Monitoring data that's collected as part of this project goes towards identifying sites of conservation significance for migratory shorebirds in Australia. The data has also been instrumental in identifying more than 170 key biodiversity areas across Australia.
I'm Dean Ingwerson, I'm the Woodland Bird Manager at BirdLife Australia, and as part of that I'm the National Regent Honey Eater Recovery Coordinator. So today we've released 50 regent honey eaters from captivity into the wild here in Chiltern Mount Pilot National Park, which is one of Australia's key biodiversity areas. And the release this week, we're going to let 100 birds go, which is going to contribute to the population and stave off extinction in the wild. The Key Biodiversity Area program is internationally recognised, so it adds a lot of support to the work that we do. One example was recently where we lobbied really hard in the Lower Hunter Valley on some key habitat for regent honey eaters, and the fact that it was designated as a Key Biodiversity Area was a really major factor in us being able to protect that site from inappropriate development.
I'm Dr. Karen Herman, and I'm a research ecologist with BirdLife Australia. I predominantly work in urban environments at the moment and am responsible for the management of a couple of our long-term monitoring projects looking at the way urban birds utilise those environments. Urban parklands and gardens are very important habitat for a lot of birds in urban spaces, so by going out and surveying what birds are present gives us a better understanding of where to find birds and what habitat requirements they have. There are a number of key biodiversity areas in our urban environment. And what we're finding through the data that we collect into bird data is that these areas are very, very important conservation sites for our urban birds. It's really important that we have good, solid data, which is held in the bird data database, because it means that we can go out to these key biodiversity areas and ensure that the management of those is appropriate for long-term conservation of the birds in those places.
Thousands of bird surveys done by everyday Australians right across the country allowed us to identify Australia's most important places for birds and wildlife. We monitor these KBAs and their birds to keep track of how our nature hotspots are faring and to guide their management. Join us and start watching and recording birds in KBAs using our free and simple Bird Data app. It is one fun way to help us look after nature's hotspots.